There, little fellow, why are you so quiet today, huh? Ian, what's the point of that? Ian, what's the point of Ian? Ian, what's the point, huh? Is that how you talk, or are you trying to disrespect me? Oh shit, what's happening to him? He's raging all of a sudden. Why are you raging, bro? I just gave you egg yolks yesterday, and you just finished them. Is that how you're showing me that you're grateful? Or you want more? You want more? You have to be a good boy, okay? You have to be patient and you have to be quiet. And then I'm gonna give you more egg yolks. Alright?
What's up, guys? I just left my crib and I need to get some salmon. Preferably like smoked salmon, because that way I don't have to cook it. Because they already cooked the potatoes, so I need to get the protein, you know, to make me some gains, man. Help me retain my gains also. And this is where I'm going. I'm going to Park Boulevard, and they have a supermarket. So they have like almost everything in there. So I'm gonna look for, hopefully I can find something, a good quality smoked salmon that's gonna be delicious. And it's not gonna have any kind of, you know, additives like sugar, you know, all the bad stuff. I'm just gonna look for a pure one, you know, pure salmon with nothing in it. Maybe probably some seasonings, but you know, some salt. The salmon smoked is always salty, so yeah.
Tell me the dates. I think these are like medjool dates or something, and then this is a dried pineapple, and I got me the tuna beans, organic with no additives. You know, it's got beans, tuna, olive oil, water, beans, some other type of beans, carrot. Olive itself and salt. Yeah, and then I got this. This is an olive oil tuna. These guys were the most organic one that I could get. The other stuff have like sugar in it and all that crap. So, hey guys, fit. Eat fit to stay fit. I'm gonna have to raise my blood sugar because I just woke up, so I need to have this or this. I can have maybe a little bit of this and a little bit of that. So, and then I can have the protein and my carbs are already cooked up, and I got me some baked potatoes. And oh my god, this is still hard. I need to what I need to do, because this one for some reason it didn't cook up like as well as the others. So I need to close the lid and make sure that this cooks evenly and thoroughly. So I'm gonna maybe start with these, and then I'm gonna let you guys know in a bit.
I'm having this dried pineapple and it's so bomb, and I'm just thinking if, like, whether I should give it to this guy right here or not even, like, you know, try it, because I don't want to mess up his digestive tract. I have some. No, this is too hard, so if he eats it he might just, you know, choke himself to death, so I'm not gonna do that. So I'm gonna have it myself. I already had one. I'm gonna have more. I'm gonna have it one day. I'm gonna start my potatoes boiling nicely.
Oh. Okay, so this is the tuna in olive oil. This looks delicious. I can see the oil on top. And this is my baked potatoes. So, yeah. So, I got extra potatoes that I don't want to have. This is the fourth one. This is the biggest one that took a while to cook, because I don't know, for some reason it was just taking a while. It was so hard. Now it's okay, it's still kind of hard, but I'm thinking to give it to this bad boy right here. You want to have some potato for the first time, some baked potato, a penne? He's like, yeah. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna chop these a little bit, little pieces. Yeah, guys, let me give it to you. I can't. You guys, so I just gave him like a little bit of potatoes. I kind of mashed it up, so it's kind of like mashed potatoes. And I think he had a first bite, but then he went back to his food, so I guess he doesn't like it. You don't like it, do you? Do you, Mr. Charm? You like that? What is that in your mouth, man? Some redness in there. What is that? Is that the food that's stuck in there, or is that your skin, your feather? Yeah, guys, so hopefully he eats this. Thank you.
Columbus, Ohio, to what he bought in Australia. Well, he represents well with his posing artistic style for a guy that's 6 feet tall. And he's one of Arnold's favorites. Arnold actually really loves him some Cedric McMillan. And we bought into the idea that if this guy dried out one time and won the Olympia, it would be a game changer. I think he doesn't necessarily have to be Mr. Olympia. He's changing the game right now.
Alone from the U.S. Army, Cedric McMillan. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from the USA, John De La Rosa.
John's actually one of my athletes. We started working together earlier on this year, probably January this time. Kind of just missed our peak a little bit yesterday. We didn't bring our best. Feel that we...
Franco's love and new Mr. Olympia, Brandon Curry.
Well, there you have it, fans. Brandon Curry is your 2019 Mr. Olympia, the 15th in our 55-year history.
Brandon Curry doing exactly what he said he was going to do when he won the Arnold Classic, which was come to Las Vegas and win the Mr. Olympia. If you believe it, you can achieve it. And he did just that. And William Bonick surprised a lot of people here tonight, Neil.
Yeah, I mean, every single one of those athletes have to walk away being happy with what they've achieved as far as their places. Brandon's obviously the new 2019 Mr. Olympia. William coming in second. The first time he's come second, he's come third, he's come fourth. So he's moving forward in the right direction. Dexter Jackson's moved up a place. He's got 1 year older.
Age right now, this is not going to be a dominant Olympia run here because all of these guys can take turns in the next 3 to 4 years winning this championship.
That really would be fun to have that kind of openness every year to battle it out for the top spots.
I just remember William, Hadi.
So I just came here with my friends. They're having some hookah here, some shisha, and I'm just chilling with them, you know. This is a place, you know, it's a pretty ass place. Cute spot, you know. It's called Chinar. It's like an Asian place. They have like sushi, you know, seafood, beef, steaks, everything. So I just had shrimp and I just had shrimp with salad and that's it. Hey guys, so my food just came. I'm at my favorite spot and check this out. Voila! Look at this beauty. Look at this. Guys, it looks amazing. Look at this meat. And I got me some aubergine, a kind of a salad, mixture of aubergine and tomatoes. And I got me a regular salad. And then I got me a watermelon juice. I'm keeping it clean, you know what I mean? Just had a meal, and do you know how good it feels when you have a nice meal and then the walking, you know, after, right after when you start walking, you just enjoy like the walk so much, because the food kind of, I realize when you're having a delicious food, right, if it was a tasty food, kind of something gets kind of stuck in your brain, like the memory of it, you know, so you don't just forget about it like as soon as you leave the place. It kind of stays in my stomach and it kind of stays in my brain. It's just so, like, psychologically, it's just so funny, you know, how things can just get you know, stuck in your brain, even though, you know, you've been like, you're not there anymore, but you know, the food is just, I'm just enjoying the walk more because of the food, because the food was so good that I'm actually enjoying this walk even more. So I just want to let you know this, you know.
Check this out. Check this out. Indonesian Cultural Festival. That is sick. That looks so sick. That's the McDonald's. The 20th year anniversary. And that's the McDonald's right there. That's the McDonald's store. That's the 20th year anniversary. Selling some stuff. Look at this.
Gelin birbirimizi alkışlayalım dostlar, sesiniz gelsin, sesiniz gelsin bakayım ve tabii ki Cenab-ı Sefir, alkışlarınız gelsin. İndonezya'nın Azerbaycan'da resmen Cenab-ı Sefir'i bizimle beraberdir, teşekkürümüzü bildireyim ve hususi bir konaklarımız var ki hal-hazırda ben onları salamlıyorum, bizim yanımızdadılar ve indi hal-hazırda we have a quiz and questions, yeah? Dostlar, ben bir sual veririm. Düzgün cevabı bilen yerinden cevap vermir. Ancak elini kaldırır. Ve eğer cevap düzdürse, we give them one of the present. Okay? Thank you so much. Demeli belə, asan suallardır. İndonezyanı daha da gəlin yaxından tanıyaq. Ve mən indi hazırda suallarımıza keçid alıram. Ve birinci sual belədir dostlar. Ama dikkatle kulağı alsın dostlar ve düzgün cevabı bileceksiniz. Sual seslenir, kim düzgün cevabı bilir, elini kaldırır. İndonezya'nın payitahtı hansı şehirdir? Gel gel gel kardeş, gel gel biraz yakın, gel gel, kam kam kam kam kam, alkışlayak. Alkışlayak dostumuzu, alkışlayak, alkışlayak. Bravo alkışlar ve yakınlaş bizim yağımıza. Yakınlaş, sana bir tane hediye vereyim. Tabii ki bu Jakarta'dır. Ve alkışlarınız niye böyle zayıftı dostlar? Cenab-ı Sefir bizim yanımızdadır. Alkışlarınız gelmelidir. Bravo ve ilk hediyemiz var. Tabii ki İndonezya payitahtı Jakarta şehridir ve biz birinci galibimizi gelin davet edelim bizim yanımıza. Gel gel gel gel gel. Adın nedir senin? Ferman'ı alkışlayalım dostlar. Ferman bu senindir. Gel, zahmet olmasa dostlar da seni tebrik etsinler. İndonezya sefiriyle tabii ki gel bir tanış ol sen, zahmet olmasa. Bizim birinci garibimiz var. Ve Ferman nerede okuyorsan?
Nermanov'da 39 numaralı mektepte.
Nermanov rayonundan olan var mı burada? Alkışlasın birbirini. Aha, eyvallah, teşekkürler. İkinci sual. Elinizi sağlayın aşağı, ben sual vermemişim kardeş. Peki bilmirsiniz, peki diyeceğim ki Ne bileyim yani tam başka bir şey soruşacağım. Bura bakabilmeyeceğim çünkü ben dedim ama yakınlaşsın bura. Yani üzüldü sayın hanım. Demeli böyle. İkinci sahamız gelir. İmdanlı izyanın en meşhur seyahat olunan yeri haradı. Bali, bravo bravo, gelin gelin hanım gel. Hanım birinci kaldırdı elini. Hanım birinci kaldırdı elini. Gelin yakınlaşın bizim yanımıza. Alkışlayak hanımızı, alkışlayak. Davet edin yanımıza. Siz çoksuz, ben tekim hanım. Hanım elinizde bir elisi var da, ne olur size. Teşekkürler. Ha, gelin yanımıza, zahmet olmasa hanımı gelin davet edin. Hanım neyse gecikir, yubanır, geç gelir. Biz onu gözlüyürük. Ve deli bak aha, adınız hanım? Gelin siz de gelin buraya. Adınız?
Abicim Pervane.
Pervane hanıma alkışlayak dostlar. Pervane hanım düzgün cevap verdi ve Pervane hanıma xüsusi bir hediye teklif olacak. Aha, zahmet olmasa. Canım Səfiri alkışlayak dostlar. Ve o teklif edecek hazırda güzel hediyeni. Ve Pervane hanım, harada okuyorsunuz Pervane hanım? Aranı bitirmişsiniz.
Bakı
Avrasya Üniversitesi'nin tələbələri var mı aranızda? Var. Aa, ne güzel, ne güzel. Devam edirik dostlar. Növbəti bir sualımız gəlir. Biraz çətinləşir suallar. Ay, okay, no problem for me. Deməli belə. İndoneziyanın valyutası necə adlanır? De, gəl. Necə gedir? Bravo, alqışlayaq dostumuzu. Necə də xoşbəxtdir. Təbii ki, bu rupiyadır. Hər bir festivalın, belə deyək, gənimi. Bütün suallara çalışır ki, düzgün cavab versin. Mən onu hər gün görürəm burada, demək olar ki, bu insanı. Və o bizdən növbəti alqışlardan təbii ki, hədiyəni qazanır və hal-hazırda cənab təbii ki, Səfir də bizimlə bərabərdir. Təşəkkürümüzü bildirək, alqışlayaq. Adınız necədir?
Rafiq.
Rafiq bəyə alqışlayırıq dostlar. Və növbəti sual, sonuncu suala təbii ki, biz keçid alacaq indi. Və sonuncu sualımız, gəlin biraz çətinləşdirim də, nəyə lazımdır? Kömək eləyə bilmərəm, xeyr. Aha. Deməli belə. Əla. Deməli, sonuncu sualımız gəlir dostlar. Və İndoneziyanın, İndoneziya haqqında belə deyək də, Jakarta ilə biz tanış olduq. Və İndoneziyanın tanınmış hansı digər əlahiyyətləri var? Yava, sonra daha çox. Yava bir, sonra yox, daha çox. Gəl bura, gəl nəsə əlində qal. Bir dənəsi azdır. Sonra, sən daha onu təkrar eləyəndən sonra kim cavab bilir? Daha çox. Gəl bura qardaş, gəl. Gəl səndən tanış olaq. Aha, və de, sadala.
Sumatra.
Sonra?
Sonra Bali var. Sonra Florensi var.
Sonra?
Bunlar da yanılır.
Okey. Kim daha çok? Üçlü deyən olub. Yox, siz hediye kazandınız da xanım da. Səbir eləyin. Deməli belə. Kim? Gəl, yaxşı qardaş. Gəl bizim yanımıza. Alqışlayaq qardaşı. Gəl. Və növbəti bir hediye. Təbii ki, bax bu qardaşa gedir. Düzgün cavab verdiyinə görə tez qardaş, hamı səni gözləyir. Yaxınlaş.
They're gonna give up finally, huh? Every single day, man, they're playing this chess game for no reason, for no goddamn reason. Let's see what's up. Let me show you guys.
Let's see who's playing.
Is it the young people playing today or is it like the old men like yesterday? Come on, old man. Do your move, do your thing. Do
just holding on to that white thing like it's a wall. This ain't a wall, goddammit. Look at his ring. Come on, guys. I think the white guy is winning because he has more than enough. Like, there's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. I think it's kind of equal. This guy is. Oh, yeah, he moves. He moves. Come on, he's coughing and shit. I'm getting sick from it. Wearing that Puma. Orange Puma. Alright, it's gonna take long, I'm gonna leave. Look at this guy, he's... You know, yeah. He got this, guys. He has him. Yeah.
There's a big difference, right? So when you walk at the training center that I showed you, right after I finished eating, we know where the show was. This walking here on the beach, like by the beach on the boulevard, is so much better. Like, it's just so calming, and before I go to sleep, it helps me big time, you know, to make sure that I kind of clear my mind from everything and, just not think about nothing, you know, kind of erase everything that I've seen today, all the stress. So, you know, because you're by the beach, it's much more quieter. And it's not as dirty, because when you go to the trading center, there's so many people there, like so crowded, and the thing is that they smoke, right? So when it's crowded, there's not that much space, so when they smoke, you can always smell that crap, the smoke. So it's so much better. I just feel much cleaner before going to bed, you know, when I walk here on the boulevard. Please make sure if you have a beach next to you, come just, you know, stand next to it, you know, whatever, just look around. Breathe, like, you know, deeply, and just, you know, enjoy this, the breeze, the sea breeze or the ocean breeze or wherever you're at. You know, this is just so soothing and calming, you know.
I think I'm passing by the same place that I was passing yesterday. Remember that tower thing, the clock tower thing? Remember, guys, I was saying it smells like shit. Guess what? It smells like shit again. It smells like fucking shit, guys. Sorry, guys. It smells really like awful. Guys, please make sure you subscribe, like, and share, comment, please. I need your support. I think I'm gonna end the vlog here today, so I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care, peace.